three unique things.
No, I've come up with a unique thing.
It's not the answer.
But that's unique, isn't it?
Well, the players from the same team have won the award more than in... Because obviously I've told you that. There's a club who's had it, who's had...
All right, okay.
To have more than one player. Do you know what? You're right, actually. That second question is bullshit. I've given you a dodgy quiz here.
Oh, Mark, what you did, actually get a bonus point or two.
You should, yeah.
Right, so that's 2 points I've got.
Well, no, I've got
one right, and then I get a bonus point.
You don't get a bonus point for the other one, you get half a point.
I should get an apology.
It was an apology point. Because it was the fourth team you mentioned anyway.
Fine. Okay, so other than my wild flailing stab in the dark, I don't know what else might have been unique about it.
Okay. Number four.
Okay.
How many times in the 9 years so far,
mm-hmm.
like before this year, has the winner also won that year's Man of Steel award? So how many times out of nine has the winner... You would have done so much better if you'd have worked out the answers to two and three. One, two and three.
Right. Probably so. How many times? Twice.
No.
I'm close, aren't I? I can see you nodding. Okay, go on.
I'll give you a clue. It's in single figures.
Of course. Thanks. Is there another question?
Yeah. How many Australians have won the award?
Three.
Yes, can you name them?
No.
Can you have a stab? Because this might give you a clue to some of the previous answers.
Okay.
So you're getting two, because you're only getting half for two and three.
All right.
Could get more, could I? If you get these answers
right. Right. I'm really not going to be able to pluck it out of my head at this time of night, mate.
Tell you what, I'll give you the years.
Okay.
2009, 2010, and 2012.
Blake Greenwood?
No. But a Wigan player is one of them.
Oh. Lulai?
No. He is not Australian.
Of course he's not.
Although the person who won it is sort of not Australian.
Oh, for God's sake. Well, this is getting ridiculous.
In that he played for a different country internationally.
Right. Okay. Who did he play for internationally? Is that interesting?
Ireland.
That doesn't help me.
Well, that's ridiculous if it doesn't help you.
Oh, not off the top of my head, anyway. Okay. Brett, go on, carry on.
Right, so we'll go through the answers then.
Yeah.
The person who's won the award three times in its history, and I'm guessing a lot of people at home got this, Danny Brough.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
He won the first award when he was playing for Wakefield.
Oh, Christ, that is
dangerous. And then won it in 2013 and 14, I think. Which club is the only one to have more than one player win the award? We know this was a flawed question now because of the shared award that I hadn't thought about. But Castleford.
Right.
So I should have said which club is the only one to have had players win the award in more than one season. Castleford, Luke Gale, obviously, and Rangi Chase, who won it in 2012. There were two unique things about the award in 2010. One of them was that it had joint winners, and the other was...
They played for the same team.
And the other, the third,
I don't know.
Third of the two things.
We've established that, I don't know. Go on.
Well, you do know this answer. This answer is within you because you mentioned at the top of this quiz section.
This is so confusing.
About a certain position on the field.
So they weren't halfbacks.
Yes, they weren't halfbacks.
Ah.
Yes. How many times in its 9 year history?
Who were they?
Well, they were a winger and a fullback. That's right. What I'll tell you.
Oh, you're not going to tell me who they were yet?
The fullback was Sam Tompkins.
All right.
How many times...
Who's the winger? Charlie?
Well, you'll get it in a second.
All right.
How many times in the 9 years so far has the winner also won that year's Man of Steel? You guessed two. The answer is three.
Ah.
Now you have a bit more knowledge about the winners of the award. So you know that a winger won it in 2010, who played for Wigan.
Right.
Who played for Ireland.
Yeah. Brian Carney.
He was called Pat Richards, for fuck's sake.
Which is his super.
So Van Gier Chase in 2011. Can I have an easy one next? Van Gier Chase in 2011 won it, sorry, not 2012.
Flawed quiz.
Danny Brough in 2000.
Stuart's Inquiry. There's too many holes in this.
Danny Brough in 2013.
I'd have done better if you could administer a decent quiz.
And then how many Australians have won the award? You got that right, 3. Michael Dobson won it in 2009 when it hauled Kingston Rovers. Pat Richards in 2010.
Yeah.
And Scott Giroux won it in 2012 at the Catalan Dragons.
Fair play, Scott Giroux.
He had a great year, didn't he? Yeah, he did. Yeah. He had a couple of great years.
A couple of great seasons. That first season at Super League Pod as well.
Mm.
He did well, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
Fair play. Well, I'm quite certain you all did better than me, so get in touch and let us know how you got on. Any recommendations this week, Mark?
Well, other than Copenhagen, if you've got...
No kids and disposable income.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've been following a lot of the people we talk to on Twitter, but most of them are kidded up now.
Yeah, I know, that's a good point. A lot of them have had, quite a few have had babies during the, during the show.
Pod babies.
The new album by The National, Sleep Well Beast. I saw a few people raving about it over the weekend, so I got it on the internet. And yeah, I've had a couple of full listens through today on my travels, and I would say it's pretty neat album.
Right.
It's a band that sort of drifted away from my radar a little bit, probably over the last 10 years or so. But I remember they had an album in the noughts called Boxer, and I remember the self-titled album they came out with around the same sort of time that bands like The Strokes and Interpol were kind of emerging.
All right,
and they fit into that sort of area. But yeah, there's a couple of songs that are genuine, like, rocky, but it's mostly sort of a melancholy down kind of album. It's quite, based on the sort of lyrics and song titles and stuff, it seems to be an album about a breakup. That someone didn't want to happen. But yeah, it seems that way, but it's very good. I would recommend it to anyone who likes that sort of music.
There you go. Well, I have a recommendation this week, Mark, and it's going to fly in the face of your quite cool, uber trendy musical recommendation, because I decided to listen to a spot of country music on my brand new phone earlier this week, and I stumbled across one of the most country music sounding song titles I've ever heard, and thought, well, I can't not listen to this. I have to check it out. It's an older song. But the song title, right, and you'll see why I think it's brilliant, because it appeals to my stupid sense of humour, is She's Acting Single, I'm Drinking Doubles. So it's also, in a lot of ways, about a breakup that someone didn't really want to happen. I'll try and find out. Gary Stewart, I think, was the chap who sang it. But if you Google it, it's just couldn't be more country and western. It even has that sort of sound going on it. The guy sings with a real western twang. It's from the 70s, I would guess. But it probably made me laugh out loud, because it's just funny, and it kind of caught me at the right time. But the song title itself made me very, very happy.
What took you into listening to country music?
I was looking for genres that I hadn't listened to before, and I thought, I've never really listened to much country music, so I put some upbeat country on the other morning while I was getting ready, and I didn't not enjoy it.
Now, country isn't that bad, apart from, like, you know,
there's some stories, and there's some, you know, there's some quite, you know, good music in it. Was all right. I'm not going to be, you know,
I prefer
getting right into it.
I prefer, like, self-reflective, melancholy country, though.
I was listening to songs about how country girls have country curves things like that. And it was all good fun for me. And then She's Acting Single,
like,
I'm
like
Shania
Twain from the past sort of country.
No, it was all more sort of modern kind of... But it was mostly blokes, to be honest with you. But there's some, you know, I'm not getting right into it. I can't speak very eloquently about the subject. I don't have a tremendous amount of knowledge.
My favourite country singer is Jenny Lewis, who isn't really a country singer.
All right, fair enough. See, I don't know who that is. I'm not a big.
She's not really a country singer, but she basically released a couple of albums that sounded quite country, but like very much anti-country kind of vibe to it, in terms of the ethos and the lyrics and stuff.
Well, there you go. Yeah, so just because it was a funny song title, and if you listen to it, you'll probably see exactly what I mean by it. It sounds like the most country music song I've ever heard.
Wonderful.
She's Acting Single, I'm Drinking Doubles. Right, how do people get
plenty of songs to pick to play us after that, haven't we?
Well, yeah, we have. Okay, although I suspect you don't have that currently in your library, so
I do not.
Probably won't be that one. I've already written down the Strokes one. Right. If you want to get in touch with us and let us know what you think about Super League Pod and give us your feedback, there's a number of ways you can do that. We are at Super League Pod on Twitter. You can head over to facebook.com/Super League Pod and give us a follow on Facebook. If you want to send us a longer form piece or a comment or something that might have... We might have said something that, you know, I'm thinking rather Liam Watts conversation that might have got your ire up,
I'll
got your
dander up.
You have certainly pissed someone off.
Yeah.
Send us an email, superleaguepod@gmail.com. We are at Super League Pod on Instagram as well. And of course, over the weekend, the Google form will be going up for all your match reviews. And if there's a game on there, or if there isn't a game on there, then please feel free to stick it on and send us a review if you're out and about at something that's a bit more obscure this weekend. Was there anything you'd like to tell the nice people before we say goodbye, Mark?
Sorry for any offence caused by my...
Don't apologise, you're entitled to your opinion. Fuck off your podcast, you do what you want.
Fandom.
Yeah,
but it's their podcast too, isn't it?
It is, and then they have their opinions. It's all good. That's what makes us brilliant, and it's what makes it your favourite rugby league podcast. And we'll see you next time on the Super League Pod. Oh.